Okay, first adventure. We're at Sturgeon River, just located out pretty well in St. Albert, but we're coming in right at the Big Lake entrance. There's a little boat launch down here, so I'll be going off. Got the board with me. Like I said before, the handle would be nice if it was round, but this will do. So we're going to be going downriver and downwind, which would be nice, and then give you an update as we get going. All right, talk to you later. First mistake, forgot my fins. Getting those and back out. Also, reminder, when you're pumping up your board, to have the valve in the down position, not the up position, because when you release it, you'll lose about 5 to 10 pounds of pressure if you don't get it done quick. So that was a shocker. But learn from your mistakes. So we are out here, got on. A little shallow to start. Seems like we got more of a crosswind than a downwind, but we will get downwind right now. So it's about 10 degrees out, so goal is to not get wet, 10 degrees Celsius. Yeah, but as far as the launch goes, pretty easy. Into St. Albert and then see how far we get. Plan to do a couple hours at least and see how long that takes us and go from there. Alrighty. Also, that's a bit of a crosswind. I downloaded that ISUP paddle tracker, so forgot to start that. I'm just gonna get myself more into the wind here, so we'll pull it off. Not screw anything up. There we go. So that's the ISUP. Not sure if you can see that. And then record. Now just start. Okay, so it's going. Tracking it, but if you want to follow me, it should just be under Phil Daly, and do a little tracking for you today. Found the largest house on Sturgeon River. These people are living large, absolutely large. A little shallow by the this area, but big house. Big house. So a little tip that I had from watching some videos, if your fins are getting stuck, is moving your weight to the front of the board. And then what I'm just doing is about 3 feet off the nose, and then just it pops the tail into the board up a bit, which helps. So yeah, once we pass that dam, it's only, I'd say, about 2.5, 2 feet deep. Can't really see because the water's so murky, but yeah, I'd say about 2.5, 2 feet deep. And we're about 500 meters off of Meadow View Bolden. So, yeah. St. Albert train bridge, followed by another bridge. I don't know what the name of it is, but something's telling me it's Lions Park Bridge or maybe Red Willow Bridge, not too sure. Anyway, it's along the Red Willow path here in St. Albert. Pretty nice, but yeah, here's the train bridge. Lots of people get their wedding photos done around this train bridge. looks a little bit shallow up here, so I'll stay on my knees closer to the front of the board. Stay on my knees close to the front of the board. And get underneath. I will say the bird watching, if you're a bird watcher. Cool. Some nice birds out here. Anyway, let's navigate this. Few bumps on the fins. Yeah, there you go. There's your training bridge. Weird. People getting photos done around the training bridge. How's St. Albert cliche? So we're in the St. Albert now. This is City Hall right there, our theater. Just passed a guy along the river and he didn't think the river was quite ready, which he's probably right on with my fins catching all the time and the flow isn't that fast. When I said I thought I was going to be downwind, I'm upwind. So spending some time on my knees trying to get the fins up. Yeah, downtown St. Albert. Some people can start around here too. There's a few drop-ins where you could come in here, but I'm noticing if I find the still parts of the water, it's a little bit deeper. I don't have to navigate. Whereas when they, obviously you see the ripples, there's something underneath that water that's causing that disturbance. But yeah, downtown St. Albert. Bridge now. Just past the sign, this is the first bridge in St. Albert. It's kind of crazy to think. It's just right by Perron Street. Lots of people out running today and getting active, which is nice to see. It's not the nicest second day of May, but decent day. Still on my knees, some shallow parts. Okay, classic St. Albert, running to somebody who went to high school with. It's pretty funny and cool, but we're underneath St. Albert Trail now. I don't know how much further I want to go. I might actually have to go back. Just thinking about out points for my pickup. But, yeah. St. Albert Trail Bridge. Shopping center right now, and then coming up to Rayside neighborhood on right hand side here. Rayside, yeah, Rayside. It's really, really nice. So, we've got maybe another half hour, 45 minutes of me, and then we'll pop out on my knees again. Still a bit shallow. A couple big rainfalls, and it'll be back up. Bump, bump, bump. Find that deep water, right? Find that deep water. Down this way right here. Seems like that's where most of the current's going. I'm pretty sure there's a footbridge up here. We're just past these massive buildings. See them over my shoulder. Those were not there last time I think I was here. They're huge. Anyway, that's where the old Lois Hole used to be. So once I get to this footbridge, I think I'll pull out, call my ride, and then be on our way. See see how far that is. Now this is pretty. No wind, calm, bird chirping. I believe one of my buddy's houses is up here on the left. Good catch. We'll go knees from here on out. Get these fins out. Almost went for that trip dip right there. A little shallow. Yeah. Feel those fins. Yeah, I think this is where I'm gonna come up, and then I'll end up in Legion Park Ball Diamonds. Beyond here, you're just kind of paddling towards Sturgeon Golf Course, which there's a little bit more water. I would, but I don't want to get caught out there. So yeah, right here. Which bank is better? 50-50. Right side, left side. Right side, left side. Just finished, just at the other side of Legion Park, kind of bottom of Oakmont, and yeah, it's a nice easy paddle, a little bit muddy. I'll probably clean the board off when I get home, and yeah, nice day, nice paddle. Definitely recommend it and do it again. Sturgeon River, St. Albert.